to paint weights. In object mode, select the mesh and in the top left corner, in the drop-down menus, select paint weights. In the paint weights toolbox along the left, select the paint brush. I only use the paint brush and blend tool. Hotkey F is to chase the size of brush tip. In the brush toolbox, I only really use add subtract and mix. The blur water droplet tool, I use it at the end to blend out smooth out the weight paints occasionally. The green triangle here is the vertex group menu. It shows the bones that the current selected mesh is skin to. I like to go through this list in this menu to delete the bones that are not relevant to the mesh. For example, this head mesh, I have deleted the lower body bones from this list by selecting the bone name in this list and clicking on the minus on the right of the list. I have already paint weighted this hound. I am just showing some basic poses that I used for weight painting and how the colors look that indicate the percentages weighted to the specified bones. Save a variety of poses on different frames to save time, as it's easy to rotate through by scrubbing through the timeline. Select the bone of interest and start painting. Red means 100% is weighted to the bone that is selected, and it fades into orange, then yellow is about 50% and fades out to light blue as it dissipates. The tricky thing with the weight painting in Blender is sometimes random vertexes are weighted to an unknown bone, and even if I am painting it red 100% to the desired bone, it still does not show 100%. To solve this, I have to find the random bone and subtract paint at 100%. Only then will it update it to be 100% affected by desired bone. I find this happens often at open edges of meshes. Now to create eyelid control handles that are driven by drivers. Duplicate the eye bone. One for the top eyelid and one for the bottom eyelid. Rename them appropriately and make sure they have dot L at the end for symmetry to work. In Z location, right click, add driver. Purple indicates driver is applied. In this driver menu, the expression var is the speed. I am adding star to multiply the speed by however many times I want. Below the object source that is driving this expression would be your rig. Select your rig. The bone would be the control bone, select eyelid.control.l. As you can see, the effect is too subtle and slow. I need to increase the number that is multiplied. I want the eyelids to move when the control bone transforms in Z-axis. In the Z transform bar, right click and create driver. The driver box likes to disappear. Just right click and hit edit driver to open it. Copy the driver by right click and copy and paste it into the other eyelid bones. For the bottom eyelid bones in the driver, change the source bone to the bottom eyelid control bone and fine tune the expression bar speed number for each bone so it closes evenly. The drivers, much like IK, does not symmetrize, so it has to be done manually to copy and paste to each bone. The control bones I have symmetrized, but later on I moved them to be side by side on the right of the head for ease of animation as well. This is good progress. I tried following a tutorial of forward IK rigs, and it was driving me bonkers as the legs became impossible to pose, flipping all over the place. I have made some changes. In edit mode, go to the armature menu on the right side. Select the bones to show in front. Any alterations to the bones can only be done in edit mode. I am selecting the toe bone. Duplicate Shift plus D, press F2 to rename the bone to IK.L. Scale the bone to be larger for easy selection and visibility for animation purposes. You will want the axis to be the same as the original bone, as we will be constraining the original bone's axis to the new IK bone. Duplicate the bone and move it up to where you would like the knee pole bone to be and rename it. Make sure to unparent and unconnect these new control bones. Make a new bone and rename it to root_base, as this will be the new parent of all the bones. To parent, select the child bones first, then shift select the parent bone, press Ctrl plus P to parent. In pose mode, shift A to select all the bones, alt G to reset transforms, and alt R to reset rotations to neutral pose. Select the bone for setting up the IK constraints on. Go to the constraint menu little spinning bone icon. Select the eyedropper and select the rig as the source and then bone controller is the new IK bone. Remember F2 to rename the knee bone. Change the chain length to be 3. Test if the new IK bone is working. Now select the target for the pull to be the rig and the control bone, for it is the new knee bone. The pull angle will have to be manually adjusted. It's a gamble each time what the correct angle should be. Parent the new control bones to the root base bone. Keep as offset. Go to pose mode, test it out. In edit mode, select the control bones and symmetrize, make sure the naming convention ended with .L. In pose mode, select the target IK bone and go to the spinning bone icon constraint menu. Apply IK constraint. In the IK constraint menu, select the rig to be the target. The bone controlling this constraint is the IK foot bone. The pull target is the rig and the bone controlling this pull is the knee. Set the chain length to be 3. Again, the pull angle will have to be tweaked and it's not logical at all as the number is not the same as the mirrored bones. Play around with the rig, see if you like how it feels. If the IK is causing a lot of jerking and shaking in your model, then it is likely you will have to make some alterations to where the IK is or perhaps the parenting of the control bones. On the front legs, I will duplicate the second bone as the IK for this will be on the third bone. In edit mode, shift D to duplicate. Scale up the bone and center the axis to be the same as the original bone. Duplicate it for the knee bone and position it to be near the bend. F2 to rename the bones. The bones are moving around because I have animations on this armature already. This process would be easier if I just deleted the animations or saved some keys on the neutral pose. But I am just redoing this all to make a video for you awesome folks, and it's great practice for me as there is just so much to remember in the world of Blender. The front legs is the same process as the back legs, the only difference is there is only 2 bones in the chain of influence in the IK constraint menu. Make sure to parent the new control bones for the front legs to the base root bone. This is nice leg for doing karate chops. Hiya kick. Now we will rotation, constrain the old bone to the new IK bone. Select the old bone and in the constraints menu on the right apply rotation constrain. The target is the rig and the bone is the IK. For the tail, I also applied IK constraint. In edit mode, select the tip of the tail bone and shift D to duplicate. Rename it to tail IK. In pose mode, select the end of tail bone and apply IK constraint. Target is the rig, the bone is the new IK bone. Make sure to set the chain length to be 4 or whatever the length of the tail is for your rig. Also unparent this new IK control bone alt P, then parent to the base root bone control P. You can also set rotation constraint on the IK, but I think this looks bad for a tail. It would work better for a snake head. Note for animation, you can turn off the IK in the IK menu on the right. To toggle it on and off is the little eyeball icon near the top of the constraint menu. I am creating a hip control bone. In edit mode, select the hip bone, duplicate it, and scale the bone and align the axis with the former bone. Unparent this new bone. Rename it and parent it to the root base bone. Select the original bone and apply rotation and locations constraint. The target is the rig and the bone controlling both of these is the new hip control bone. Test out some hot yoga moves. Downward dog it is. Create a neck control bone. In edit mode, select the neck bone and duplicate it. Scale and align the axis. On the old bone, apply only rotation constraints. Unparent it alt P. Parent it to the chest bone. Select the original bone and apply rotation constraint. Target is the rig and the bone is the new neck control bone. Select the eyelid control bones and make the new neck control bone the parent. I am seeing what happens if I put a location constraint on the neck control bone. It basically breaks the connection of the previous parent bone. This won't work for this character at all. But I could see this being an interesting method of an octopus arms or something stretchy. To delete a constraint or any modifiers applied, hit the X in top right corner of its menu box. To reconnect bones in edit mode, go to the Armature menu and select Connected. In the viewport display of Armature setting, you can play around with the variety of visualization of the bones. I like setting up the bones in the basic octagonal format. But when I am finishing of the rig, I like the way the bendy bones look. I prefer a minimalist approach as I find animation overwhelming enough. With the simple looking bone look, I change the size of the bones in the transform menu and also in the scale size under the B-bone settings. Finishing touches is fine-tuning the visual appeal / functionality of the shape and size of the bones. There is lots of tutorials of making a lot of fancy line and mesh handles for the rigs. I don't love making rigs, I like the problem-solving aspects. Oh, and let's not forget to make the feet and knee control handles in its own layer parent root. Duplicate the root base bone and rename new bone root child. Select the IK foot handles and the knee handles, unparent them and parent them to the root child bone. Parent the root child to the root base. Bones that are not animatable, because they are constraint. It might be handy to make they very small so they are out of the way. And ones that are not animated very often on the subtle side. Well, I finished this rig. I am going to try to learn for shaders and hair modifiers next. Wishing you luck on your rigging journey. Try out some extreme poses to test out the resiliency of the rig and if it is robust enough to create the poses you hope to achieve. What a saucy personality this hound has. I think she likes her CBD gummies a lot. Thanks so much for watching and subscribing, it encourages me to keep on creating. Stay golden.